For those who have either listened to my talks, read my book, or accessed my thesis in www.inthenameofallah.org should already know that everything about Muhammadan Islam is deception and trickery made up of smoke, mirrors, and darkness. Absolutely nothing about this demonic cult belief system is what appears to be. The whole lot is based upon the contortion of facts and reality, the perversion of the meaning of words, the dislocation of history, and the willful misrepresentation of the biblical narrative. As I have conclusively proven in hundreds of chapters, that Muhammad plagiarized, plundered, pirated and or perverted every theological precept, concept, thought or idea in his Quran from the traditions, fetishes, beliefs and scriptures of the Christian Arabs, the Judaized Arabs and the pagan Arabs. That the only new items in Muhammad's Quran are the ungodly, hate-mongering, war-mongering, racist, misogynist and vile verses that fill its surahs. I have proven in chapter after chapter that Allah is not the same as the God of Abraham, Moses and Jesus. That Islam does not mean peace but only submission. That any creature in the universe that declares its belief in a one and only God is automatically a Muslim and has absolutely nothing to do with Muhammad or his Quran. That jihad is not a spiritual struggle to commune with God but eternal warfare against all humans who do not believe as Muslims do, the so-called derogatory Ummat al-Kuffar, nation of infidels. Currently, Ummat al-Kuffar is 80% of humanity, comprising all Christians, Buddhists, Hindus, Zoroastrians, Jews, animists, atheists, agnostics, pagans, etc. That Islamize actually means Arabize and has nothing whatsoever to do with the concept of Islam, which is submission to the will of one God. In this chapter, I shall demolish another linguistic deception, that of so-called radical Muslims. This term is used invariably by totally ignorant people of the Arabic language and or the Quran, as well as by the willfully and criminally twisted minds of left-wing academicians, politicians, clergy and media, aided and abetted for their own agenda by the supposed scholars of Islam. I have already incontrovertibly proven that Muhammad's Quran, his Sunnah and Sharia are hate-mongering, war-mongering, racist, misogynist and vile. Thus, they are by and within themselves radical and have no shades. Those who are believers or fundamentalist Muhammadan Muslims must, of course, follow to the letter Allah's ungodly instructions to war against all humans until one of the following three conditions is accomplished. 1. Convert to the cult of Muhammad whether they like it or not. 2. Submit in humiliation and degradation to Islam. 3. Be exterminated. To fully deceive and mislead humanity, the Islamists, aided and abetted by their left-leaning supporters in all levels of our democracies, blame all acts of terror committed by Muslims all over the globe upon the so-called radical or extremist Muslims, as if the majority of Muslims are peace-loving, law-abiding, integrated citizens in our democracies. President Lincoln of the USA once said, "One can deceive all the people some of the time, some of the people all the time, but not all the people all the time." With the internet and other knowledgeable people on the sordid subjects of Muhammad and Islam, we are in the third phase of the above circumstances. Never again will the followers of Muhammad and their supporters be able to deceive all of humanity any longer. I repeat once again, Muhammad's Quran, Sunnah and Sharia are radical. They have no shades. Osama bin Laden, Al-Zawahiri, Taliban, Muslim Brotherhood, Hamas, Hezbollah, Shabab, Mullahs, Ayatollahs, and the scholars of Islam are neither radical nor are they extremists. They are the true believing fundamentalists who are only slavishly and utterly without remorse following Allah's and Muhammad's instructions in his Quran and Sunnah to the letter. It is the text of the scripture that is radical. They are only the psychopathological clones of Muhammad who have no choice as believers but to emulate each and every instruction of his. Muhammad's legacy for hundreds of millions of his male followers is to turn them into hate-mongering, war-mongering, joyless, misogynist, envious, frustrated, racist, unhappy, and vile creatures. The living, dead, zombies that we watch with horror, their contorted and twisted faces, on TV almost every single day from all corners of the earth. In fact, the truly radical Muslims are the ones who want to live in peace and harmony with Ummat al-Kuffar, hence are automatically considered apostates and not Muslims. For those who may have forgotten what Muhammad's Quran instructs its followers, or those who are new to this series and are shocked at my statements, please pay attention to the following verses from Muhammad's Quran, only a few from among thousands more of similar connotation. Al-Tawbah 9.29, fight, qatilu, those who believe not in Allah nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden which had been forbidden by Allah and his apostle Muhammad, nor acknowledge the religion of truth, Islam, even if they are of the people of the book, Christians and Jews, until they pay the jizya, poll tax, with willing submission and feel themselves humiliated. I shall now recite it in Arabic for those who still doubt my Arabic background. قَاتِلُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا بِالْيَوْمِ الْآخَرِ وَلَا يُحَرِّمُونَ مَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ ولا يدينون دين الحق من الذين أوتوا الكتاب حتى يعطوا الجزية عن يد وهم صاغرون. المائدة 5.51. O ye who believe, take not the Jews, Yahud, and the Christians, Nasara, for your friends and protectors. They are but friends and protectors to each other. And he amongst you that turns to them for friendship is of them. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا اليهود والنصارى أولياء بعضهم أولياء بعض ومن يتولهم منكم فإنه منهم إن الله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين. العمران 3.85. If anyone desires a religion other than Islam, submission to Allah, never will it be accepted of him. And in the hereafter, he will be in the ranks of those who have lost. ومن يبغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. العمران 3.56. As for those disbelieving infidels, pagans, Christians and Jews, I will punish them with a terrible agony in this world and the next. They have no one to help or save them. العمران 3.118. O you who believe, take not into your intimacy those outside your religion, pagans, Jews and Christians. They will not fail to corrupt you. They only desire your ruin. Rank hatred has already appeared from their mouths. What their hearts conceal is far worse. And finally, Muhammad 47.4. Therefore, when you meet the unbelievers, smite at their necks. At length, when you have thoroughly subdued them, bind a bond firmly on them. I dare anyone listening to point out if there is anything ambiguous about the contents of these verses, even though they are in English. Ladies and gentlemen, Muhammad told his followers 1400 years ago that war is deception. Ummat Muhammad has been at war with Ummat al-Kuffar for the last 1400 years and continues to be. They are allowed taqiyya, which is Islamic religious subterfuge, to be conducted against all unbelievers until such time as the Muslims are strong enough to overthrow and overcome the very democracies that have given the Muslims harbor, freedom, justice, financial, educational, and health care. So much for Islamic gratitude and Muslim loyalty. It was Muslims who were celebrating all over the world the collapse of the Twin Towers and the slaughter of 3,000 American civilians. The ones who celebrated the most were the Palestinians. Not once have the so-called silent majority Muslims ever demonstrated their disgust or anger at what the alleged radicals and or so-called extremists are doing in the names of Allah and Islam. The same not-so-silent majority who turned out in their thousands in Europe and the USA about Muhammad's cartoons. Those followers of the religion of peace were actually demonstrating their true character with the destruction of properties and lives reflecting their anger. In the degenerate value system of Muhammadan Islam, cartoons about Muhammad are infinitely more important than the death and destruction of human lives at the hands of these so-called radical or extremist Muslims against both unbelievers as well as other believing Muslims. Not once in over 30 years of Islamic acts of terror all over the globe did these unfounded silent majority Muslims demonstrate or shout out loud, not in our name. Why? Because as Muhammad also said, silence means consent. Their deafening silence means they actually consent and support what these presumed radical or extremist Muslims are doing. I rest my case.